गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ वकार अहमद, योर इकोनॉमिक्स टीचर फ्रॉम कैम्ब्रिज इंटरनेशनल स्कूल दसुआ। एंड एज यू आर अवेयर, वी आर स्टडींग चैप्टर नंबर 10, एंड टूडेज लेसन इज़ द लास्ट लेसन ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 10, गवर्नमेंट बजट एंड द इकोनॉमी। टिल नाउ वी हैव कवर्ड बजट, इट्स ऑब्जेक्टिव, रेवेन्यू बजट एंड कैपिटल बजट। टूडे वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट बजट डेफिसिट, बट बिफोर दैट लेट अस recap the previously studied topics. So first is composition of government budget. We all know that government budget can be classified into revenue budget and capital budget. Then revenue budget consists of revenue receipt and revenue expenditure, and capital budget consists of capital receipt and capital expenditure. Revenue expenditure is that expenditure of the government which neither create asset or reduces liability of the government, whereas revenue receipt is that receipt of government which neither reduces assets nor creates liability of repayment. Similarly, capital expenditure is that expenditure which either create assets or reduces liability of the government, and capital expenditure is that expenditure which either creates assets or reduces liability of the government. Now, capital budget. Capital budget consists of two parts, capital receipts and capital expenditure. Capital receipt consisted of borrowings by the government and small savings by the government. Both of these are debt creating capital receipts. Then comes disinvestment and recovery of loan. Both of these are non-debt creating capital receipts of the government. Then capital expenditure consists of creation of assets by the government, disbursement of loan by the government to state governments, union territories or other PSUs, and investment in shares of PSUs by central government. All these are parts of capital expenditure. So this was capital budget. And now the last major topic of chapter number 10, which is budget deficit. And as we all know that if a situation of deficit is arising for an individual, for a firm or for a government, it is indicating to the point that expenditure part of the budget is greater than the income part of the budget. So let us define budget deficit. When government spends more than it collects by way of revenue, it incurs a budget deficit, meaning the expenditure of the government is more than the income or revenue of the government. This will create a situation of budgetary deficit, and it is of three types: revenue deficit, fiscal deficit or primary deficit. Or more technically speaking, it refers to the excess of total expenditure. And expenditure is of two types, revenue and capital, over total receipts, which is also of two types, revenue and capital. So it is the excess of total expenditure over total receipt of the government. This is budget deficit, which is of three types. I am repeating: revenue deficit, fiscal deficit and primary deficit. Now this budgetary deficit can also be studied in a more elaborate or detailed way. So when government expenditure is equal to government revenue, it is known as balanced budget. I have indicated it through a equation. Government revenue is equal to government expenditure, then it is a balanced budget. Now what if revenue and expenditure are not equal, greater or lesser than one another? Then it will create a situation of unbalanced budget. Point number two, when government spends the amount less than the revenue it collects, means expenditures are less and income is more. This is known as surplus budget. Again, shown by a equation, government revenue greater than government expenditure, situation of surplus budget. And now comes the third situation, when government spends the amount more than the revenue it collects, indicating government expenditure is greater than the income of the government. This is known as budget deficit or deficit budget. It is wrongly indicated here as surplus budget, point number 3. You need to correct it. Now, the first type of budget deficit or budgetary deficit, which is revenue deficit. It refers to the situation when revenue expenditure is greater than revenue received of the government. Revenue deficit is equal to revenue expenditure minus revenue received. Now, we all know that revenue received consists of tax receipts and non-tax receipts, but tax receipt is the most dominant part of revenue received of the government. On the other hand, revenue expenditure is of different types, but the amount government spends in the functioning of the government is the major part of revenue expenditure. So by using or by explaining these definitions, we can safely assume that if there is a situation of revenue deficit in an economy, it is indicating indirectly that the tax collection of government is less and government is spending more amount on the functioning of the government. For example, salaries of the government employees, pensions of the government employees, or the money being spent on the ministers of the government, on the foreign tours of the ministers and other government dignitaries. So basically, revenue deficit, if it exists in an economy, then it is indicating that the management of government is not correct. Government is collecting less tax, whereas it is spending more amount on its upkeep or on its running. Now, what will be the implications or effects of revenue deficit on other sectors of the economy? We all know that revenue budget is that budget of the government which belongs to its current expenditure, unavoidable expenditure, and recurring expenditure. So if a government incurs a revenue deficit, then it is implying a situation of dissavings, minus C bar for a government. So if a government is dissaving, mean expenditure is more and income of the government is less, then how will government arrange that dissaving part of the money? Then government will cut expenditure on other sectors, other parts of the government to fulfill these commitments of the government. For example, and why revenue expenditure is called as committed expenditure? Because revenue expenditure consists salary of the government employees, pensions of the government employees, subsidies to other sectors, which you cannot avoid. We cannot say that a government employee will not get a salary in a month because government is dissaving, so you'll not be getting a salary. It is not a situation. So what happens? To fulfill the revenue expenditure or committed expenditure, government reduces expenditure on other parts of its economy which are generally productive. So what is happening here? Productive expenditure is being reduced to fulfill the committed expenditure or unproductive expenditure of the government. What will happen? It will lead to lower capital formation and lower economic growth. So lower economic growth will be showing that the welfare of the people is reducing. Now the second type of budgetary deficit, which is fiscal deficit. Fiscal deficit is the difference between the government's total expenditure and its total receipts excluding borrowings. So let us talk in detail. Fiscal deficit is that the deficit or the main deficit of a government, which is the difference between total expenditure, and total expenditure consists of revenue expenditure plus capital expenditure minus total receipts, revenue receipts plus capital receipts. Now, if you will see in the formula, we have written as total expenditure minus not total receipts, revenue receipts plus, because we have written excluding borrowing, and in capital receipt, two receipts are debt creating capital receipts, which are borrowing and small savings. We have excluded them here. So the formula comes to be ग्रॉस फिस्कल डेफिसिट और टोटल फिस्कल डेफिसिट इज इक्वल टू टोटल एक्सपेंडिचर माइनस रेवेन्यू रिसीप्ट प्लस नॉन डेट क्रिएटिंग कैपिटल रिसीप्ट. Why have we used the term non-debt creating capital receipts? Because we have excluded borrowings from fiscal deficit, and those two debt creating capital receipts have been excluded. So fiscal deficit formula can also be written as total expenditure minus total receipts excluding borrowings. So basically, and you need to remember this point, that gross fiscal deficit or total fiscal deficit of the government is equal to total borrowings by the government. So basically, fiscal deficit is indicates that total borrowing requirement of the government from all the sources is the fiscal deficit of the government. And how can government, or how does government finances these borrowing requirements? Is from the home, means government issues bonds to the public, to other financial institutions, to banks, and they subscribe to the government bond and government get its borrowings. At home, domestic level, then government borrows from RBI, that is another, or that is the major part of a government borrowing. Then borrowing from abroad, like loan from IMF, loan from World Bank. And if you are aware, for this current pandemic situation, World Bank has committed a loan of $2 billion to the Indian government. So this is the part of borrowing from abroad. So let me summarize this fiscal deficit for you. Fiscal deficit requirement or gross fiscal deficit is equal to the borrowing requirement of the government, and government can borrow or government can finance its borrowings at domestic level from RBI and from international market. So what will be the implications of fiscal deficit? First, keep it in mind that if you wish to measure a health of an economy, then the first parameter used is always fiscal deficit to GDP ratio, means how much is the borrowing of government against the GDP of that economy. If it is larger, it indicates that government finance is not healthy or government is not investing enough in productive work, or more is being invested in unproductive work. So this fiscal deficit is the primary source of measuring the stability of the government, economic health of the government. Now, if you will go to that fiscal deficit formula, then we can write it like we have written here. Fiscal deficit is equal to revenue deficit plus capital expenditure minus non-debt creating capital receipt. I will be explaining this formula more in detail when you will receive the PDF note. So let us assume that this is the situation, that revenue deficit is a part of fiscal deficit. And we have already talked that larger revenue deficit shows more is being spent on unproductive work. And then to spend on unproductive work, government need to spend less on productive work, or government reduces its investment, which leads to less capital formation. So larger fiscal deficit indicates larger revenue deficit, which means that less is being invested and more is being spent on unproductive work of the government, which is not a good thing, or we can forthrightly say, which is a bad sign of finances of the government. So now comes the last of the deficits, which is primary deficit. Primary deficit is the difference between fiscal deficit and interest payment of the government. We can write it like gross primary deficit is equal to gross fiscal deficit minus net interest liabilities of the government. And how can we calculate net interest liabilities of the government? As we know that government as an institution borrows money as well as lends money to state governments, UTs and other parties of the economy. So net interest liability will be the interest payment means the interest which government need to pay at domestic level to RBI or to international financial institutions minus the interest government will receive from the domestic lending. So the difference between interest paid minus interest received at domestic level is net interest liability, which when we subtract from gross fiscal deficit, we reach at gross primary deficit of a government. So the basic idea behind primary deficit is to correctly know the current year's borrowing requirements. Let us assume that there are two situations. Fiscal deficit is zero, meaning there is no accumulated debt or there is no previous borrowing by the government. So fiscal deficit will become zero and there is or there will be no interest liability because government has not taken any loan. So current year's borrowing requirement is equal to primary deficit. Now the second situation, if primary deficit is zero, then interest payment will be the only payment government need to do, means there is no current year's borrowing requirement and whatsoever primary deficit is, that is just because of the interest payment on accumulated debt. So keep it in mind, primary deficit shows current year's borrowing requirement. So what are the implications of primary deficit? The first and the major implication is that we measure primary deficit to know that what is the situation at the borrowing level of the government, means how much government is spending more than its revenue. If primary deficit is zero, it is meaning that government need to borrow just because of previous debt. This is the major implication of primary deficit. Now some practical problems have been given based on the budgetary deficit we just talked about. You need to solve this problem using correct formula and remember that by writing the formula in solution, you secure one mark. So if you will just put the values directly and show me the answer by doing plus minus, then one mark will be deducted at board level or at a school exam level. So whensoever you are solving any numerical, you just need to write the formula first, then put the values and follow this procedure here as well. Now let us talk about the solution of practical problems given in the last class, in which you were to identify whether the following is a capital expenditure or a capital receipt with giving reasons. So the first question was receipt from sale of shares in Indian Railways by government. So if government is selling its shares, it is disinvestment and it is a capital receipt, because disinvestment leads to reduction in the assets of the government. So it is capital receipt. Second, money deposited in recurring deposit in post offices. When a common person deposits money in post office, it is categorized as small saving and it becomes capital receipt because all type of savings are liabilities on the government, means they create liability of repayment. So deposit in post office is a capital receipt. Third is purchase of metro coaches from Japan. It is capital expenditure because coaches are assets and this purchase is creating asset for the government. Then receipt of ₹45,000 from sale of government bonds by RBI. If you remember, basically this is an open market operation or it is borrowing, and all the borrowings are capital receipts because borrowing creates liability of repayment. Second question means the next question is basically same. Loan of ₹50,000 by US government for infrastructure projects, loans and advances and borrowings all create liability of repayment, so they are capital receipt. And last one is construction of 12 new IITs by government. Creation of IIT, creation of asset by the government, and creation of asset is capital expenditure. So this is capital expenditure. So that's it for today, students. Tomorrow we will start with recap of chapter number 10, or maybe you will be provided a quiz to solve, and that quiz will be of limited time period, so you need to revise the chapter and attempt that quiz, which will be based on the last 4 or 5 lessons in which we have covered chapter number 10. Till then, stay healthy, stay inside. Bye.